Welcome to the .NET MAUI TreeView Control Tutorial. The Syncfusion .NET MAUI TreeView Control is used to present data, specifically hierarchical data like organizational structures and nested relationships. In this video, I will demonstrate how to add Syncfusion's .NET MAUI TreeView Control to a .NET MAUI project. I will also show you how to populate TreeView nodes using a data source and item source, as well as how to programmatically expand nodes. Before you begin, ensure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application. Then, give the project name and location. Next, create a project with the .NET 7.0 framework. The default application is now ready to use. Before going any further, let's set up the application's environment. Here, I select the Android emulators from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. After selecting the emulator, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code, so wait for a few seconds. Now, the application's home page is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the TreeView control into this application. First, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI TreeView NuGet package. I open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI TreeView package and select it to install in my project. Once the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. Open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. It is necessary to register a trial license key to use Syncfusion MAUI controls. So I open the AppSAML CS file and add the register license method with a trial license key. To learn where and how to generate the trial license key, refer to the link in the description for this video. Next, navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. Remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI TreeView and TreeView engine namespace. In this example, I am going to display the hierarchical data of the country Australia, its states and cities in a tree structure. To do that, I initialize the TreeView control and define the nodes property to add many nodes. Next, to represent Australia as the root node, create a node by creating an instance of TreeView node and setting its content property to Australia. Then, add child nodes under Australia for each state. For that, create an instance of the child nodes collection, and within this collection, add a child node for each state, such as New South Wales, Victoria, Queensland, and so on. After that, under New South Wales, create child nodes for cities like Sydney, Canberra, and Newcastle Maitland. Repeat this step for the other states and cities. See that the country of Australia is displayed. When you tap expand button, you will see a list of states displayed. Similarly, when you tap the states expand button, they will reveal the cities within them. Next, I add the nodes for the countries Brazil, China, India, and the US. You can see that all the countries are displayed in a similar hierarchical structure. To have the Australia node expanded upon initial loading, set the isExpanded property to true. Now, observe the Australia node expanded on initial loading. Similarly, if you want to expand the child nodes, such as the states within Australia, set the isExpanded property to true for all the country nodes of Australia. Look here, all the child nodes of the Australia country are expanded on initial loading. Now let me show you how to create a tree view by binding the item source. Before starting, remove all the nodes. I import the existing model and view model class files to display the tree view for files and folders. The model class contains the subfiles, item name, and image icon properties, and the view model class contains the information about the subfiles and their names. All the icon images are stored in the image folder in the resources. Now I import the local namespace in the main page XAML. Then I set the view model as the binding context for the content page. After that, set the item source to image node info and child property name to subfiles. Next, need to set the item template for the tree view. To do that, add an item template with a data template. Inside the data template, include a horizontal stack layout and set its spacing to 15. Within the horizontal stack layout, then add an image instance. Set its source property to image icon and specify the vertical options, horizontal options, height request, and width request. Additionally, add a label to display the file name. Set its text to item name and configure character spacing, font family, font size, and vertical text alignment properties. After the application is loaded, you will be able to see the folders. When I tap on a folder, it will show the files in a tree view structure. Finally, I will demonstrate how the nodes can be expanded when loading the tree view by using the auto expand mode property. To expand the root nodes, set the auto expand mode to root node is expanded. By default, its value is set to none. Looking here, only the root nodes are expanded, and the camera roll folder is not expanded because it's a child node of the pictures node. To expand all nodes on loading, set auto expand mode to all nodes expanded. Observe that in the pictures folder, the camera roll folder is also expanded. In this video, I demonstrated how to create a .NET MAUI application and integrate a Syncfusion TreeView control into it. I showed how to populate TreeView nodes using a data source and item source. Additionally, I demonstrated how to expand the nodes on initial loading. To learn more about TreeView features, check the documentation link provided in the description for this video. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.